Canada Goose. You guys might know that I live in a city, Old Hanseatic City in the Netherlands, which is situated along the banks of the River IJssel. It's a beautiful river. And especially in the winter, a lot of geese will come over here to spend the winter. There's a lot of agricultural land with grass fields, which are being well taken care of by the farmers. So they have a high nutritional value. And the geese really like that. So there's a group of Canada geese now. You might know they're not really migrants. They originally come from Canada and have been introduced in Europe. But we also have a lot of grey-legged goose. There's also a lot of white-fronted goose. And occasionally there are also some birds who come from far, far away and somehow ended up in a flock and they continue to walk around the flock. So two rare goose are reported around my city. The snow goose, but that's not even in my app. So I found that one already. It's not so far from here, but I don't know if that's a snow goose. I do not have that much experience with snow goose, so I have no idea, guys. What do you guys think? I will show you some video right now. Like I said, I don't have much experience with snow goose, but to me this looks like more like pigment problems in the feathers. So those feathers do not have any pigment. It rather looks something like that to me. There's also what I think you guys call the Brent goose. That's really a goose that shows up a lot in the Netherlands in the winters. We call it the fire goose. I have no idea. Well, it's called fire goose. English. Oh, the barnacle goose. You guys call it the barnacle goose. And between the barnacle goose close by, there's also the red-throated goose has been seen for a few days. I tried to look it up yesterday as well, and I had no luck. So I'll see if I can find it again. Maybe it will show up. As you see, I'm in my mobile hell, otherwise known as a car. It's terrible weather outside, so I'm not going to bother a lot with trying to get nice compositions and everything today. So I'm just going to see if I can find that red-throated goose, because that's a pretty goose. I also want to see and try if I can get some goose in the rain, because the rain might actually give something that I think it's interesting to do a little bit more problems with. Right, I'm off to the other location. It's on the other side of my city, so it's a bit of a ride. And then let's see if we can find that red-throated goose. I love to ride along the river. Occasionally we go out just to enjoy the views. Quite often we will see wildlife as well, such as roe deer or the white-tailed sea eagles. And then there are always surprises. I was driving slowly searching for the geese when I saw a buzzard diving down, probably trying to catch a fall. Oh, that buzzard! Oh! How cool was that? And I'm quite used to a buzzard sitting on a fence pole on the side of the road, but if you stop the car, they always go away. And I saw this buzzard on the other side of the field on a fence post. He was hunting for voles. But then I was riding on this road because I wanted to check out some a couple of the goose over there as well. And he sat on this dead willow. Oh, how awesome was that? I think I have a few nice photos from that. Let's hope something nice comes out. And something nice did came out. I'm so happy with this photo. It's really hard to photograph buzzards. So when I was given this chance, and there's a photo as a result, I couldn't be happier. But it did require some processing. Due to the poor light, the ISO was really high. With the Topaz software, Dinos AI, I was able to bring back a lot of details in the feathers, making the photo usable from an otherwise really grainy RAW file. If you ever want to buy the software yourself, you can use my discount code JKWildlife for a 15% off. And if you use my affiliate links, it will not cost you anything more, but I will receive a small commission, so you will help this channel out. Back to my mission to find the red-throated goose. It was clear that I was now in the right area, as I was finding large flocks of grey-legged goose and barnacle goose. But finding a single red-throated goose amongst thousands of other goose, it's not easy. I spent hours searching for that single goose. But so far, no luck. The geese had as much interest in me as I had in them. Oh, so many goose. Just my luck, probably flown back to Siberia. Although I did not find the red-throated goose yet, I did make a few photos I am happy with. You might know the saying, bad weather make good photos. I really like these photos of these white-fronted goose. The rain really adds to the story of these animals. This is the exact group where that red-throated goose was sighted in. It's only grey-legged goose right now. I was here a few hours ago as well, and there were a few barnacle geese as well, but there was no red-throated goose between it. I might be able to get a few nice photos actually of them, because the background is quite far away. Let's see. The road sort of gives nice leading lines. Well, that red-throated goose would be really nice if it was over there as well. I did not spend a lot of time making photos, as I really wanted to find that red-throated goose. If I would have spent more time, I would probably have been able to capture some more interesting behavior. I think I'm gonna continue. There are a few other groups over there as well. So let's see if we can find in between those goose. We were nearing the end of the day, so I was getting a bit cranky. The weather was also not cooperating, and the rain was pouring down hard. And if that all combined wasn't bad enough, there suddenly was a helicopter chasing all the goose up in the air. Oh, that was weird. It was a helicopter just flying really low, so all the geese went up in the air. No idea why a helicopter would fly so low over here. I did try to make some photos with a long shutter speed, so I hope a few turned out nice. I quickly hit the dial and set the shutter speed to 1/25th of a second. I know with the experimental photos like these, most of them will fail. Only a small percentage will be keepers. There is a fine line. If there is only a little bit of movement, it is out of focus. If there is too much motion blur, then the viewer cannot see what the photo is about. In the end, I used two photos, so the entire photo would be filled with the interesting patterns of these flying geese. As color is not adding to the photo, I used the Silver FX plugin from the Nik collection to make the photo black and white. I really like this result and curious what you think of this photo. Let me know below. Despite not finding the goose that I want, I think there's a point to be made. I think today's vlog shows, even if you do not meet the goals that you have set for yourself for the day, you can still return home with a lot of images that you like. And there's always tomorrow, right? So join me again next week, where I will continue my search for these rare geese. Do not forget to hit the like button and do subscribe if you haven't already. And then I will see you again in my next vlog.